Welcome to this node breakdown for MARDINI 2024 with Grayscale Gorilla. This is day 19, and today's node is the Joint Capture Biharmonic SOP. So the Joint Capture Biharmonic SOP is a SOP level geometry node, so we can go ahead at the object level, dive inside, and just drop one of those, Joint Capture Biharmonic. And you'll see that it has three inputs, a rest geometry and a capture pose, as well as an animated pose. So all this actually requires is a geometry. So let's first give it a geometry to add capture weights to. So let's create a line, give it 50 points, set to round tube, add end caps, and increase the columns. Just something like that. That's going to be our rest geometry, right? So this still won't work over here. And that's because we also need a skeleton. So to do that, we're going to go over here into our viewport, press space and 3 to go into front viewport. Then over on the right-hand side, let's just drop a skeleton. So this over here will allow you to draw out a bunch of joints. So we're going to set our display flag on that and template our sweep. And just like this, we're going to add a few points. So we're going to click from the top and then just add a couple of points. Right. So these are just going to be bones. Press enter and that's our skeleton. Space and 1 to go back to perspective mode. And let's just make sure that it's in the center of our geometry. That's perfect. So now we can go ahead and just plug that into the capture pose as well as the animated pose. When we go ahead and do that, you'll see that it generates these two over here for us. The one on the left is just showing the capture weights for each one of the joints that are coming in from the skeleton. And the one on the right is showing the tetrahedralized version of the mesh of the left side. So before I show you what this is actually doing, let's see how we use that. Let's go ahead and just use a rig pose. Over on the right side, we'll take this animated pose over here. And then we'll also use a joint deform. Right, so a joint deform over here, and this is going to take these three inputs. Set our display flag on our joint deform, and on this rig pose with it just selected, we're going to go over to our transform handles, and we're just going to rotate some of these points. So that's what our joint capture biharmonic has done for us. It's taken this geometry, it's applied the skeleton, and with a rig pose, we can go ahead and adjust the various joints that make up this geometry. And the way that this works is it takes our incoming geometry and converts it to a tetrahedralized mesh. A tetrahedralized mesh is just this mesh over here where we have these internal struts and internal geometry. And this just allows for the sort of deformation where we're having volume preservation. So back to our joint capture biharmonic. These settings over here are going to be for generating this tetrahedralized mesh. For the most part, you can leave it at adaptive, but a lot of times you will change it to uniform. Now, uniform is just going to make sure that each one of these triangles is a similar size. When we have adaptive, you'll see that where this sharp edges, it'll try to create more triangles. And this is fine, but if we have a complex mesh, it can often slow down in those areas. So you'd want to switch to uniform. Over here, you can adjust the uniform scale. So you're increasing the minimum size that a tetrahedral can be. And then you also have the max size over there. As for exact, this is going to give us exact triangle sizes, just like that. And then finally, we have embed. And this one is only going to approximately match the incoming geometry. And this is going to be useful for flat objects. So if you have something that's, say, a grid, then embed is going to be a useful one to use because it's not going to perfectly match the geometry. It's going to just generate a tetrahedralized mesh that more or less follows the shape of the geometry. So I'm going to switch back to adaptive over here, and then we can take a look at the other options down here. This resampling over here is for the skeleton that's incoming. So this is going to increase the resolution of the skeleton that's incoming. And as a result, you're going to get better weightings for each joint. And that's all we have to look at right now. We will come back to take a look at blend factor and scale attribute. I just want to show you how we can adjust the weightings of our joints after we've already run the joint capture biharmonic. So as you can see, we have these soft bends over here. And this is dependent on the joint weighting that comes out of this joint capture biharmonic. What we can use is a joint capture paint, plug it in right over here. And on this node, we can go ahead and paint particular joints. So over here where it says target joint root, just click on each one of these. So that's 0.0's weighting. This is 0.1's weighting. And you can see that 0.1 has most influence over the area in the middle over here. Now these areas where it's smoothing is what results in these soft bends. If we go back over here and just click over here to make this a stronger weighting, you can see that when we go back to this joint deform over here, we now have these sharper creases, right? So we can do the same for the other joint. So just go to 0.2 and we'll do the same thing over here. Right, so now if we take a look at our joints, it's now bending very sharply. Now, let's say that that's not exactly what we want. This is where the other joint capture biharmonic comes in. We can use it over here, plug it in after our joint capture paint, and it'll redo all of the calculations that we did with the first one. But what we actually have over here is this blend factor, and this blend factor allows us to blend between captures that already exist and the ones generated by this node. So if we drop this to zero, then it's going to fully use the joint capture of this joint capture paint. If we push it up, this is the one that's generated by this joint capture biharmonic. And if we go over here, you can see what this does, right? This is the one that we painted, and we can blend between the two, right? So we can find a weighting that we're happy with, maybe something like that. The only other thing that I want to show you is just the scale attribute over here. So sometimes we may want to adjust the tetrahedral resolution based on an attribute from our incoming geometry. So over here, I'm just going to add an attribute wrangle. And all I'm going to do is just say at target scale is equal to v at p.y. And we know that position is going to be 0 at the bottom and 1 at the top. So if I visualize this over here, target scale, you can see that it goes from low values at the bottom to high values at the top. If we go over to our joint capture biharmonic and then use this as our scale attribute, you can see that the bottom gets high resolution and the top gets low resolution. So of course, you can also paint these values in, you can find clever ways of generating it. And just like that, you have even more control over the tetrahedral mesh that's generated. The cool thing about this is that it is all procedural. So if we go back over here to our skeleton and we just go to modify, we can actually add joints in between over here, and this will still work, right? So now if we go down to our rig pose, we can make other adjustments and everything still works. So there's other weird things that you can do. For example, if we had to use a rubber toy and an ISO offset, increasing sampling divisions and then scattering some points into the volume, we'll just scatter something like 10 points. We don't even have to have a skeleton. We can plug the scatter node into the skeleton over here and it'll generate the attributes that we need. Plug the rubber toy into first input, the skeleton into second and third input, joint capture biharmonic, and then to a joint deform. And then we have this weird thing if we use a rig pose where we can actually take those points and use them for just random deformations, right? So you don't even have to have a skeleton. You could actually just mess around with some random points and have them weighted based on the joint capture biharmonics. So there's some super, super strange things that you can do with it, and it's really kind of interesting. So feel free to just mess around with it. Even more strangely, you can even use something like an attribute noise on this rig over here. And because these are just points, what we can do is just plug this into P. We can do a zero-centered noise, a lower element size, reduce the amplitude. I'm just going to remove the rig pose over here, set this to animation, just to see what these points are doing. Yeah, and then we take that into our joint deform, and we end up with this super weird thing. Right, so we can end up with really strange results, but they're pretty fun. So do keep in mind that these are just points. So once we've captured the weights onto our geometry, we can affect them in whichever way we want. And then we just use the joint deform, and this takes in all of the information that it needs to actually deform our incoming geometry. That's all for this video. Tomorrow is day 20, and we're going to be looking at the ragdoll solver sop. So I'll see you there. Bye.